been in short film making for the last 9 years. How do you think has the scene transformed?
While I started making films, there was no HD cameras available to our exposure. All these DSLRs with high definition format or all these latest good cameras, it was not there. I was actually shooting my first film in a PD-170. It has now reached such a level that high-end productions, which would have costed like very heavily maybe 5 years or 6 years back, has now come to a stage that we can actually do it in 50% of the production cost. So the ideas which all these filmmakers would have found it difficult to do 10 years back can be easily executed these days in a minimal budget. Now, when a filmmaker starts up a project, he exactly knows, okay, who are his target audience gonna be. So if it's just gonna be some viewers in the film festivals, then it can be, what to say, it can be planned in such a way that this can actually end up with producer, what to say, not cutting his hand.
What is it, the title? The title itself looks at two dimensions, color and sound. Visual and
it's like
audio.
Color is something which actually gives life to whatever we are seeing. See, monochrome is always great, but color is something which gives life to whatever we are seeing. In our culture, it's bended in such a way that we always have an attachment towards color and celebration. Ad is made in such a time when India is winning the World Cup finals.
It was in 2011.
I was literally standing on a roadside watching a TV in a shop while I was saying it. So literally everyone around me was celebrating. That celebration, if a person who can't hear it, when he sees it, he will feel that. In that, his younger sister helps him to watch that winning moment of India.
Okay.
So basically, I was blending in that moment of celebration and happiness which a deaf person will have when he will understand well. Legends of Tomorrow was a sports documentary.
It was in football.
It was about football. In that, I had to actually shoot about CSR activity in which they were selecting talented Indian footballers and they were sending them to Argentina.
Mm-hmm.
So the basic job assigned to me was to make an emotional piece of 10 minutes
okay.
of the entire process of 6 months which they had done.
Mm-hmm.
So my shoot was spread across 5 cities in India. So I had to shoot in Goa, Calicut, Kolkata, Shillong and Chandigarh. And the people I have met, the experience which I have got from that is something which I will cherish for a long time. Because the kind of culture which I am going to shoot into every third day is different.
Okay.
So every people I mingle with, the third day is different. They talk differently and the family background from which these players have come.
Mm-hmm.
And we had to do intense research to select 5 or 6 kids to feature in that documentary from around 250 profiles which were given to us. Every time it's a dream for all filmmakers to do a movie, something about something which has been like, which stays as a question in their mind for a long time, a subject something like that. In conversation with God is something like that for me. Because it's basically a conversation between an agnostic and a God.
Okay.
About what the job of God is.
Okay.
And this, just like I said, the movie was called Verbose, but I don't see it that way. The movie is just conversation for 20 minutes.
Okay. It reminds me of a very old English film called The Man from Earth, which had a similar conversation with various spiritual characters put in a room.
Okay.
So
I see each project as a learning experience where I can learn something new every day. And for a filmmaker, each day is a learning lesson. And every project is a learning lesson. Even this conversation which we are having, after a point, if I sit back and think about it, I might get some insight in that. It might help me to improve my work in future.
You come from Malayalam film industry, so which is known for its offbeat movies.
Yeah.
How do you differentiate yourself making a short film, which is which is going to be even more concise, even more offbeat in an already offbeat film industry?
Now, what has happened is, now everybody is a short filmmaker.
YouTube is flooded with short films.
Yeah, it's like because of this DSLR thingy and everything. And most of the films are actually good. What already people are expecting is, we are going to say something in 5 to 9 minutes or maybe okay 20 minutes up to the point only. Whatever we are seeing, each shot should be up to the point. Every single element shows a different aspect of story. maybe you sitting here using a blue pen, instead of that, if you use a red pen there, it actually defines a difference in your character. So it's like that precision and an eye for detail is highly necessary when you have to do a short film in Malayalam. The last time I did a Malayalam short film was 4 years back. So my last short film was in English.
Okay.
The taste of the audience is what you treat them with. So all this commercial stuff or all of the masala movies which you give, you keep on giving to them. It's like a drug, it addicts them to that. So with this range in which all these screens, all this YouTube thingy, internet thingy, everything is going on, it's now proper time that we can actually change the taste of people.